we have that feeling that how much we need God. There's a saying, the moment that we have nothing, the more we need God. Tama ba? So there's danger of having many things. But it's about a matter of how we see ourselves. Are we satisfied without God? We are happy for having visitors here. We need many visitors now. I'd like to recognize Edward's family. Edward's family. The family. Our friends. I also see from our SST for GC Company, Sister Hanasa. This morning, or this day, is the regular program, every quarter only. So every first Sabbath of the quarter, we have communion service. So the first part is the Sabbath school, and the second part is the hour of worship. For this reason, we have a very short message for our hour of worship. A message of reminder. So please open your Bibles to John chapter 17. Bibles to John chapter 17, verse 17. I did not prepare a PowerPoint for this short sermon, but rather invite you to focus on your Bibles. Maybe that will be projected, and that is now the projection. By the way, for those who wrote their names in a sheet of paper, to volunteer to become facilitators, because if ever there are 100 people, sorry, there is, we need 25 facilitators. If ever we have 60 participants for class or interest, we need 15 facilitators. We need more facilitators. So please give your sheet of paper to Brother Joy Lee or Brother Jimmy Subandan or Brother Handel Cabrera or Pastor Staff. Okay, I think your Bibles now are prepared. Let us read together. I am reading from the New International Version, and what is on the screen is from King James. Sanctify them by the truth. Your word is truth. Shall we bow our heads for prayer? O Lord God in heaven, this morning we come to you, Lord, to set our mind at you, to receive your words, to make us feel your presence. Forgive our sins and empower us and fill us with the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. Amen. Sanctify us from the world set apart. Make it different, make it special, holy. If you have 10 boxes of fruits, you want the 10 as yours, you make it separate. One time we are coming from Surala, all of us bought pineapple. Parihamat purma, pinya, prato kayo din, 50 bungkus ano, buka to pagyuhan. Prato, 50. So, parihamat sa kabungkus. All of us riding in the stomachs, both same, no? Naghihis ang kabungkus. How do I know that that is mine? So, I put a sheet of paper. This is mine. So, in other words, that will happen. Many times I use this. When we are provided during seminars or meetings, we are provided with a bottle of water. We have the same bottle, the same water, while hanan. How do I know that this is mine? When we go sometimes outside and it is besides the other bottle of water, how do I know that this is mine? Sometimes I put, I scratch the label. There's something different. But how God knows and how the world knows that we belong to God, that we are God's children. How do they know that we belong to God? We are God's children. Sanctify them by what? By the truth. And what is the truth?
Thy word.
The word of God is truth. This week we have the week of prayer entitled The Sanctified Life. And we learn from the life of Daniel and from the life of John the principles of Daniel, the appetites and the passions. Even during the time that his friends went to the faithfulness, what makes the difference? They stand for truth. When Daniel was trapped by his friends, not Shadrach, Meshach, but the fellow workers, and then he was trapped into the lion's den. And the character of John, the ministry of John, when John was exiled, from the life of Daniel and John, we learn the life of a sanctified life. In short, this morning, like someone, we are sanctified by the truth. Daniel and John stand for the truth. They stand for the right though the heavens fall, because we know what is the right. We may have the heart to stand for the right, but the question is, what right I am standing for? Whose right? Hindi rights, ha? Human rights. Katuwon, the right thing, the correct, the truth. What is the basis that you have this? This is right and this is wrong.
Truth, the word.
The truth in the Bible. We are sanctified by you. The people of God knows that the Bible is the word of God. As written in Psalm 119, verse 105. Please open your Bibles. Psalm 119, 105. Thy word is what? Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light for my path. Since the word of God, the Bible, since his word becomes our God, since his word, the word of the Lord, is the guide of our life as we are living in this dark world, God is bringing us to the right direction that makes us different from other people. The word is the lamp unto my feet. Can we claim this one? That every day we are guided by the word of God. Do you have your Bible? Your own Bible? Habang may inyo ang magalingong Biblia, nabalik ang tuwa ang magalingong Biblia. The Bible becomes our basic and the only principle in life. How it happens to us? I believe nobody's here lived long time ago that this is not your second life. Naba? No. And I believe if you are now 20 years old, kasi mga 20s din, 20 to 30. No. Below 20 years old, please raise your hands. Below 10 years old. Okay, pwede ako. Below 20 to 30, please raise your hands. 20 to 30 years old.
Oh,
okay. 30 to 40. 30 to 40. 40 to 50. At least you know your bracket. 50 to 60. Okay. 50 to 60 years old. What's my point? At least you know our bracket where we belong. And what we only know is what we have been before. Prabhupada said, there is wisdom in white hair. You understand, Pastor? Because the best teacher is your and prayer experience for those who follow you we learn from you. It can be either we learn from your success or we learn from your mistake. But for yourself, you already learn what you have experienced. But whatever age bracket we belong, we never know what will happen ahead of us, do you? Except what is written in the Bible. That's why the Bible says, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path," because we never know what will happen tomorrow and what will be the best option in every moment for me and what is now the direction of our life. 2 Timothy, last verse, last passage that we're going to read. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verses 16 and 17. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verses 16 and 17. All scripture is God breath in King James, is given by inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. The words of the Lord becomes our light and our lamp, because this is used as God wrote this one through His holy people, inspired by the Holy Spirit, to give us the right thing to do, the doctrine of life. Kung sama na kung doctrine, what the Bible says. And it is for reproof, pagbadlog sa atong mali. When you do such thing and that is wrong, the Bible will say, that is wrong. So when you study your Bible, there are times that it will reprimand us. Mali na, so ay, di kayo ko. But the good thing there is, for correction. This is the right thing to do. It's not only saying, wala ba gini ka lang na autoritarian. Mali na, puro sa mali ka lang sa bata. Mali na, puro lang yung mali, puro lang bando. Ayaw na buhata, ayaw na buhata. Ilang bata ko sa parang buhata, what shall I do now? When the parents said, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this, puro sa God. That we had confusion and have an anger to the children. Don't do that, don't do that, don't. But God is giving us, has given us a good example of becoming parents. And God is using this Bible not only for correction, not only for reproof, but for correction. Don't do that. This is the right thing. Kanisya, muli buhaton. There is an option. Don't go there because this is the right direction. The Bible has this instruction. It will correct us and it will instruct us. It's not only saying this is the right thing to do. It's not only up to that point, but it is how to do the right thing. How to do the right direction of your life. In righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Unto all good works. How is our life in the Bible? This week we have studied two men, Daniel and John. But their last of lessons in the Bible. And every time you read your Bible, you can always get food for your soul. What are those that you need to be corrected? And what are those that we need to learn? in living with others, pagkinabuhi kaubag sa pagtao, o pagkinabuhi sulod sa itong pamilya, kung sa mga natong angin pagbabiyahan o angin natong pag-aspon, hinawa ang Ginoo. Magkatulog sa atong kasatasan kasi kasi muna ko na pinaagi sa tulong na nama sa inyong pinaganan. So ang hagit ka ang puntago, patuni o panahon ang inyong Biblia. The challenge this morning and the appeal and the hope of this morning's lesson is have time for your Bible. Have time to study by your own. Our communion service, our foot washing is there. Maybe we have times during the quarter that we fail, we relapse. God knows how weak we are. What God wants from us is we have a humble heart to come to Him once again. That's why we have this communion service. We know what the Bible says. By then, we still do different things. God knows that we are weak. That's why He said we need to be washed by His blood. Communion service is intended for everybody who knows Jesus Christ. We certainly have been pleased welcome other denominations who are baptized in their churches and they live according to what they know is true. So welcome them if you are baptized in your churches. You can join them for washing and communion service. And for those certainly have been families, their children is not yet baptized, so they cannot join. Only those children who are baptized can join. Because this is in the Asama Deposit of the Baptism.